late. Beautiful supporters in the crowd. I'm shy.
Work it, lady. Go on. You're looking great. Samoa haven't played for a medal since winning the tournament in Cape Town, looking to get their way through to a semi-final, taking on Uruguay, who have never been to a semi-final. Kickoff is stroked, and this is where Samoa is so good. Contact in the air, though, as it was brought down by Letufia. So early penalty goes against Uruguay.
Quick call, too, by Jordan Waite. It's always good when the referee's efficient and clear, keeps the game going. Big moment for Uruguay, though. I think they were the surprising, impressive team of day one. Massive kick from Samoa, but it doesn't find the touchline.
Oh, Falaniko has banged this long, long, and it's from the penalty. Go. Dead and goal, and so Uruguay, after conceding that early penalty, the mistake from Fafoi Falaniko gives Uruguay a 22 dropout here, a 22 restart. No breeze to contend with in the stadium.
No, it's a beautiful stadium. Anyone can kick this.
Okay,
just has to be behind the 22. You can choose to go short, retain possession, or go long, get territory.
They go short to try and retain that possession. Lichtenstein it was who puts the kick up. It's come off a Uruguay hand. Couldn't be scooped up though by Apelo Maliko, leading try scorer this season. And well, what have we had? Penalty, couple of mistakes, and not a lot of rugby yet from these two teams, but a tension on quarterfinals day.
Absolutely tension. As you said, the very first cup quarter, Maliko, little error there, very unlike him.
Steady two balls in, make sure you hook.
Leading stats all over the places. Maliko, too, top try scorer coming into Singapore. Second most line breaks out of everyone coming into Singapore. And there's that stat you were talking about earlier. Samoa have won every single game the last 9 times. But hey, finals 40, baby.
Kijima Lichtenstein feeds the scrum. Samoa try to put some pressure on, but finally we might see a little bit of attack from one of our teams as Uruguay with possession caught on the 22 as Bautista Basso. One of their key try scorers, key weapons for Uruguay. As I said, made the quarterfinals in Cape Town pre-Christmas, which is the tournament Samoa won. And that's a nice little ghosting run from Basso again, cleared away by James McCubbin. Now Uruguay starting to get their game rolling a little bit. Here's Tomas Echeverri flirting with that sideline. They showed him it, and Samoa dragged him out over it. Good defence.
Just muscled over the try line there. Malosi strong, but they want to go quickly.
Away go Samoa. They are so lethal on the counter. Uruguay have got themselves back and organised really well to stop Niu Lavia. Samoa, as I said, scored a ton of tries yesterday, 15 of them, and now looking to roll forward here through Niu Elliott. Letufia, ball over the top, all linked up, found his man, Paul Scanlon, on the left shoulder, but Scanlon couldn't control it.
There were options too. He had options either way. He must have got the call, the talanoa, the talk on the inside, but just couldn't link up with that pass. We have another look here. Replay straight away. Great break initially from Tuitama. And then we know how fast Letufia can be, but Scanlon, who's also been an amazing performer this season, unable to control it.
They had such consistency of selection, Samoa, throughout this season as well. I don't know Malani Matavao at the moment, but these guys, Maliko, Afasua, Scanlon, Letufia, they've all been there through the thick of this season as they put a big shove on, but
must go up on both sides.
Shoving up, and so it's another penalty. It's a game being played between the 22s at the moment.
Massive scrum there, and it's so easy. If you've ever done a 7 scrum or even a 15 scrum, not that I know much about those, but in a 7 scrum, it's if you don't get that right side up, the left side is the loose side, it wheels around. So when you're putting all that pressure in, you've got to be balanced in how you do it. So Uruguay, I think, one of their best shots at an attacking position here.
Guillermo Lichtenstein, who kicked the penalty for Uruguay to beat USA yesterday, and here he comes on the wrap around the number 9. And again, ball just couldn't be controlled as the shot came in. Basso was always grasping at it. So, another knock on. There's a lot at stake for these teams.
Oh, Tuitama, he learned this one off his coach, Brian Lima, the chiropractor. Ball carrier, no chance here. Boom. Right in the bread basket. He'll feel that one tomorrow. Beautiful shoulder contact. Creating a knock on as well. Gosh.
Gosh, I love a good tackle. Well, these teams, Uruguay, are in the real battle with Spain to secure their survival in the series next year automatically. Samoa at the other end trying to secure an automatic Olympic qualifying spot. So they're sitting seventh, but they're only 5 points behind the fifth place South Africans, who of course didn't make the quarterfinals. So there's a lot at stake at either end of the table for each of these teams. If they can get through to a semi-final, that is big competition points, let alone the tantalising prospect of a trophy. Here comes Samoa through Va'apelo Maliko, one of their best all year, and now bumping off some bodies. Finally, the dam bursts. It's Taunu'u Niulavea who gets the score, and Samoa's on the board.
Niulavea just brushing these people off, brushing defenders off, and of course it's Maliko with the sneaky little footwork. He knew his big enforcements were coming. And Niulavea, who also had a great day one, puts it down.
Well, after a lot of errors and handovers of possession, it is Samoa who cracked the Uruguayan defence first of all to take a 7-0 lead.
Samoa flag is up, flying high. 685, baby.
We're going right.
Samoans rep the area code. He's gritting his teeth, he's in this. But massive, four tries, three line breaks. Absolute performance by Niulavea this weekend.
Fafoi Falaniko gets us back underway. And oh, had hands on that, did Lichtenstein. And couldn't control it, should have been able to bring it down, and it's more possession here for Samoa and Tuna Tuitama, who stabs a little kick ahead, trying to get around the outside. Tuitama ball spins, rolls, and doesn't quite get there.
I think it's gone dead, but I just want to check it.
He's going to check it, but I think it's Leai. I think it's no. It's worth another look, though, isn't it, Rick?
So it's shoulder to shoulder.
Well, just so that we can,
okay,
we can see the good skill. Not going to get there, though.
About up by Uruguay, wasn't it? But I think it touched the white blade of grass just before he kicked it. Game of
Jordan,
centimetres.
I have a decision. The ball has been kicked dead by Samoa,
okay,
so options.
By Samoa, we thought he was going to say Uruguay then, didn't we?
Kicked dead by Samoa, so 22 or scrum. What would you like?
Good bit of skill though from Tuna Tuitama.
No, scrum or 22.
Didn't quite pay off, but they like Chip putting that little one back in behind to the Samoans. There they are, sitting seventh, but nothing between them and fifth place South Africa in that Olympic qualification race. Remembering, too, you've got New Zealand, Fiji, Australia and Samoa all play out in the Oceania region. So that makes it, and one team from each region will qualify through on the non-automatic spot. So that is why, particularly for Samoa, those Oceania teams, you can get your automatic Olympic qualification now. Saves a lot of headaches.
Knock on.
Another mistake made to end a bit of a scrappy half from both teams. What, just the one try in at this first quarter final. But it's Samoa who lead Uruguay 7 points to nil.
Do I habla español?
No habla español.
I don't speak much Spanish either, but
I'm on.
If I was them, I'd be looking at four missed tackles compared to Samoa zero. If they could clean those up, they're a good defensive team. I think they'll, you know, it's only 7-0. Be much further back into this competition.
Second half underway in our opening quarter final, just 7 points to nil. That's a good start for Uruguay, securing possession from the restart, which they weren't able to do in the first half. A lot of mistakes from both teams in the first spell. As now Mateo Vinales gets away, ball is a little untidy and stolen illegally, so off feet.
Left arm on the ground.
Was Apelo Maliko.
Nice here.
Yeah, he clearly described left arm on the ground as the pitcher he saw. Maliko, just not quite into his groove, but we all know what he's capable of.
Uruguay have never beaten Samoa. And they're not, yeah, I was going to say, not one of the better teams coming from behind, only twice this season.
Good news though, four of their 10 tries were from set piece yesterday, and this is a very good set piece for them to start that form again.
Yeah, they'll go from line out, and they do take some nice ball. That's great ball off the top for Lichtenstein to work with, and then clattering onto it. The great hard hit, Arcos Paredes, one of their leading scorers. Ball's come off the foot, and did really well to scoop it up as Basso shovels it along for Vinales. Stopped on the 22. Promising here for Uruguay. First chance of really putting some good pressure on the Samoan defence. Lichtenstein looking for Echeverri on the outside. Samoa have looked after him well though. Through the middle, Diego Ardal, the captain, trying to create some space wide for his flyers. That's a good carry too from Bautista Basso. Still there for Uruguay and McCubbin, retaining possession well. Got to maintain their patient build up here. Nice ball wide once more for Echeverri. Big man standing out on the right. Ball sitting there for Ardal to play it. They've just been going side to side on this 22. Samoa picking them off at the moment. Good footwork and the offload there for Vinales from McCarbon. Lichtenstein holds on. And now Bautista Basso trying to get around the outside with a bit of footwork. Change of direction. Backwards flicks it out the back. Forward. Ball's gone backwards. And Vinales picks it up. And the patience does pay off for Uruguay. And it is Mateo Vinales who scores to get them back into this quarterfinal.
Oh, slowly but surely, Vinales. Offload game was a relentless Samoa defense doing all they could, but in the end, Vinales in the right place at the right time. Vamos, amigo. This is how what they wanted off that set piece attack.
Kick is good, low, flat, and hard. That'll do, and we're all square, 7-all in the quarterfinal.
Gets the goods for his team. Also very difficult to play with apparatus on your face. I tried it once. You know, it affects your vision, affects everything. But it's also very brave. You can let it get into your mental, but he has not this tournament. It's been very impressive.
Tell me when you're ready, I'll call time.
Not easy to do.
Okay.
It's actually the worst when your physio says you can play but you have to wear this.
Let's go.
Almost become his trademark and as a scoring tries for Uruguay. He's got his team back into it all. Hands on it. Now danger. Samoa lethal from possession like this. And Scanlon just skins Uruguay on the outside. Paul Scanlon hits spin, gets a little bit closer. They strike straight back to Samoa.
Tato wall. Let's go. It's Scanlon. Gets down the sideline. We've seen him do it so many times. There is no room to work with there. Absolutely nothing. Ardal, the captain, giving all he can. But the Samoan speed, too much. And the blue uniform goes over for a well-deserved try. Off the post, though. It's only a five-pointer, but that's the reply Samoa want. You'll notice Uruguay had to work phase after phase for Samoa. The way they play, it's very quick in reply, and the fans are here for it.
I'll keep time off.
Samoa go back in front, 12 points to 7, just under 3 minutes to play in this, the first quarter final.
With 2 minutes 44 to go, who scores next, Ricky?
Okay.
Very
so take,
important.
Take time, get set, and then you can go.
Obviously
okay.
For the scoreboard, but mentally too.
Reset. You good? Yeah.
Falanico. To reset some fresh legs coming off of both teams.
Come on now, please.
And again, it's knocked down. They eventually get hold of it, do Uruguay. They'll take it cleanly, but it went backwards in the process, and they'll get a penalty. No clear release from Mutu Apitai. Apitai, excuse me, who made the tackle.
Almost had it. There's a couple of calls now for Samoa not gone their way. They probably have to look at what the ref is seeing.
Gives Uruguay great attacking possession though once again. Up towards halfway or tried to offload that in pretty heavy contact. Protesting the point, Ignacio Alvarez. He was the one who tried to release it out the back and it's fallen for Samoa who set a scrum here just on Uruguay's side of halfway.
Uruguay did well yesterday because of their offload game, but they're playing Samoa, who also are extremely good at their offload, so they know how to defend it. And
chance here for Samoa to really turn the screws as Tuitama flies down the left, bumps off one, gets through a second, stretches, scores. Tuna Tuitama, that could be the one that ices this quarterfinal to Samoa.
Yeah, big moment. Doing it strong, doing it well, and doing it for Samoa. He's been everywhere, his Tuitama. Setting tries up, chasing the ball to the end, and this time the leg drive was too much. Over he goes, and a Samoan flag flies high for that one.
Ready?
10-point advantage now for Samoa.
Come on.
Across the face, but so that 10-point buffer, 17-7 with less than a minute to play for Samoa.
Good effort, good nudge, not quite here.
Come off, please.
And with 11 carries, Tuitama takes a rest on the bench. 30
Time's
seconds
off,
to take the conversion.
Off, please.
That's that clock that winds down.
Okay, thank you.
Makes sevens really exciting. And then you've got another 30 seconds to take the restart for the kickoff.
Okay, let's go,
so
please.
You get to quarterfinals, you get to
time
finals
on
day.
When he kicks it, I'll call
it's
it
really
on.
Important to use that shot clock to your advantage.
Time on, please.
Time goes on. The guy can't bring this in again, just bobbles out of the hands of Fasciolo.
Advantage is over.
Here's Niua Lovea, one of the try scorers, gets an offload for Apelu Maliko. He was about to be driven over the sideline. Instead throws a wonder ball to the series leading try scorer who puts Samoa into a semi-final.
Oika, fair, fair, far out. You take one monstrosity off in Tuitama and you bring on Niua Lovea and they're just powerhouses. Uruguay doing all they can to try and get the Superman out, but they cannot do it. And there's not one but two also backing him up, ready for the offload, and of